The old adage that it's impolite to talk about politics or religion has suddenly become a matter of life and death with the abortion issue. Political correctness propagated this myth that it is gauche and makes people uncomfortable. Because if politics and religion are discussed, the hypocrisy from the liberal media would be exposed. They do not want thinkers but followers who do not question what is happening. Why is this happening? It is because there's no longer any respect for life, our country, or our traditional beliefs in our values of fairness, truth, sustainability, and integrity. This results in political correctness where their logic makes no sense. The Christian religion and the Ten Commandments are laughed at, except when it advances their political agenda, is convenient, encourages diversity, or supports cultural issues. Several states have finally confronted the abortion issue by passing laws that calls abortion for what it is. It's murder. They made it illegal for a doctor to terminate a pregnancy after a heartbeat is detected. I find it incredible a law permitting a killing of a child, even after it's born, acceptable, much less legal. But that's what New York and North Carolina celebrated in the spirit of protecting women's health and her personal right to her own body. The irony is, supporters typically are against the death penalty, support animal rights, allow gay marriage, and encourage gender identification awareness for children in grade school. The bottom line is their entire liberal agenda centers around their disdain for life and the desire for political power where the end justifies the means. They believe all problems in the world are a result of too many people. The agenda of man-made climate change, gun control, abortion, euthanasia, gay marriage, animal rights, illegal immigration, and higher taxes all have their solution based in the logic that fewer people who don't think would be easier to control. This would allow a socialistic government to function where the liberal elites are in charge. Capitalism, Christian morals, patriotism, economic freedom, and the family unit are all roadblocks to advancing their agenda of a new world order where hard work, freedom, personal responsibility are no longer traits that a socialistic government would value. We must continually expose this hypocrisy where our core values are preserved and not let the accusation of discrimination, intolerance, or old-fashioned core values stop us from doing what made this country the greatest country in the world. This is Keith Kuby wishing you the best in making the world a better place.